Hey everyone, this is Lisa from Life in Layouts over here on the scrapbookingstore.com. I am using the July 2020 upgraded kit as well as this sketch from Page Maps from February 2015. Now I am going to be following the sketch as it is on the background, but my photos are going to look completely different. And that's what I love so much about sketches, is that you can take one aspect of the sketch, use that aspect, and then nothing else. And that's what makes the sketches work the way that they do. I knew that I wanted to use this flamingo paper when I saw it in this Best Summer Ever kit from Echo Park. So I decided to take the big chunk that's on the left-hand side of the sketch and use that with the flamingo paper. I first started out with this gingham paper on the left and right-hand side. I was going to split it between the two, but then when I added that paper on the far right-hand side, I felt like I didn't have enough color in the layout. So I will end up changing that piece of paper here in a few moments. These photos are of my mom when we went to the Bahamas for her birthday a few years ago. And she was just being silly when we were on the dock. This is after we had ported. So we had just gotten off the boat and we were about to explore the city. And I wanted to take some pictures of her next to the water. And she was just being silly in those photos. So what I decided to do was cut three of the photos down to a 4x4 and line them up on the far right-hand side of the left-hand side of the layout. And that gave me the space that I needed to mimic the flamingos that are on the paper. I go ahead and distress all of the edges of my paper. And as I was distressing the pink gingham, that is when I realized that I needed to change it up a little bit and add something else to it. So what I decide to do is use this stripe pattern paper, and it's actually going to span from the very far left-hand side of my layout all the way until right before the scalloped edge of that paper on the right. And so I cut pieces of it and tuck it behind the flamingo paper as well as my photos. This is a great way to get more use from the paper, especially when you only have a single sheet of paper for a double page layout. Once I get all of the papers down, I do go ahead and add my photos. Now the three photos that are in the 4x4 size, they are laid flat to the layout, and the two other photos, I do use fun foam on them. I decided that the photos were getting lost on that busy paper, so I went ahead and mounted them on this pineapple paper, and it just gives it a little bit. You really can't even see the pineapples in the paper. It just gives it some green and yellow background and kind of ties in those colors from the other pieces. I also pulled out the flamingo chipboard pieces as well as this flamingo like float looking thing because I knew I wanted to use both of those. I do want to encourage you guys to go and check out the Facebook group for scrapbookingstore.com because there is lots of inspiration over there in regards to what you can do with this month's kit as well as past kits. So if you are wanting to see what you may be able to get in all of these kits and what you can make with them, there is definitely lots of inspiration there. I will link my affiliate link below. So if you do decide to purchase something from the scrapbookingstore.com, if you will use that affiliate link, it does help me out a little bit, but please don't feel obligated to do so. I went ahead and pulled out one sheet of paper that is not included in the kit, and that is that polka dotted paper on the far right hand side. I just needed a solid or a background type paper for that flamingo piece because I felt like the flamingo piece was getting lost in that paper with the rosettes on it, and so having that polka dot piece there really made it stand out. The one thing that I don't like about this kit is that it doesn't have really good B-side paper, and that's just me. I prefer B-sides over A-sides, and if you're not familiar with that, B-sides would be like the flamingos are A-sides of the paper, and the B-sides are usually plaids or stripes or ginghams, things that are polka dots, things that are not necessarily very themed. And that's what I enjoy scrapbooking more, because I tend to not scrapbook theme specific. And this kit just didn't have it, which is not normal for Echo Park. Echo Park tends to have lots of great B-sides because it is one of my favorite companies. All right, so enough about my B-side paper love. Let's get back to the layout. I do go ahead and put my title down. I just looked for titles online that involved flamingos, and this Stand Tall and Be Fabulous is one of the ones that came up when I Googled flamingo sayings, and I just thought that that was perfect for my mom because that's what she's just doing there. She's just being fabulous. Now, I do know that fabulous is spelled wrong in the layout as it stands. When I went to edit this video, I realized that it was spelled wrong, so I went in and changed the spelling of it to make sure that it was spelled right. So you will see in the close-ups that it is spelled correctly. All right, everyone, so here is my final layout as well as some close-ups. If you enjoyed this video, if you wouldn't mind giving us a thumbs up, we'd really appreciate it. If you want to see more inspiration from the scrapbookingstore.com, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Thanks everyone for watching, and I hope that you have a scrappy day.